Everything you need to know about hoppers in 5 minutes or less. Let's go. To craft a hopper, you're going to need 5 iron like this with a chest. Hoppers look like this. Every 4 ticks, a hopper will try and take an item from what's above it and put it in the direction that it's pointed. The area that a hopper takes from is within this block. So for instance, if you have a half slab or a trapdoor or a carpet or any of these containers, as well as the minecart containers, composters don't work. However, they will take the bone meal out once it's generated. Furnaces and all of its variants will take the output from the furnace once it's done smelting. A hopper below a cauldron will pick up the item even if there's water within it. A hopper below a brewing stand will take any bottle that's put in it. A hopper below a dirt block won't pick it up unless you turn it into farmland, a grass path block, or if it's soul sand. Hoppers do not work on ender chests. Now we know that a hopper will take the items from a chest that's above it and put it into a chest below it, but if you have a trap chest, it won't take the items until the chest is closed, and the same thing works at the bottom, for if you open the chest, it'll stop dispensing items into it. Hoppers cannot be pushed by pistons or pulled by sticky pistons. A hopper will send items through the chain even if there are multiple hoppers in the chain, and even if one of those hoppers goes towards the sun. A hopper minecart will collect items much faster than a normal hopper. You can take a comparator output from hoppers just like any other container. If I take items out, the signal strength gets weaker, and vice versa. The pipe found at either the bottom or the side of the hopper indicates which direction the hopper will try and send items. If you place hoppers on a furnace, the side input will only collect fuel, while the top one will take an input, and when it's done smelting, the hopper on the bottom will collect the output. If you have a hopper running into another hopper and place items into it, they will be taken out 2 at a time. If you have hoppers placed like so and place items in, the items will still be taken out 2 at a time, but they will be split up evenly amongst the 2 hoppers. However, this won't work if the hopper is taking something out of a container. If you place 2 hoppers running into each other and place an item in, the item will go back and forth continuously. Using that same idea, you can take a comparator output to either create an item counter or a countdown timer. You can use hoppers like so to create an automatic sorting system. So if I place these items in here, they will begin to be sorted into the proper chest. And anything that doesn't belong will be sent into another chest. And that was everything you need to know about hoppers in Minecraft in 5 minutes or less. If you think I missed anything, or if you liked this video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in another video. Bye-bye.